You are about to hear How I Raised Myself from Failure to Success in Selling by Frank Bettger, read by the author.
I'm Frank Bettger. The album you're about to hear is not a scientific analysis of sales psychology. It's simply the story of my professional life, the strikeouts, the errors, the failures, and how I replaced them with success, happiness, and financial security. But before you listen to it, I want to say something to you personally. If you were my own brother, I would say to you what I'm going to say to you now. You haven't got much more time. I don't know how old you are, but let's assume, for example, that you're about 35. It's later than you think. It won't be long before you're 40. And once you pass 40, time goes so fast, you can hardly believe it. I know. I'm far on the other side of the half-century mark myself, and I just can't believe it. Time goes so fast. Now that you're ready to listen to this recording, I think I know how you must feel. You're naturally curious, perhaps a little bit skeptical. You're not sure whether this is going to help you or not. Well, I can tell you right now that when you have finished listening to the entire album, one of three things will happen. First, nothing. If you do nothing about it, listening to my story and the principles it contains will be a total waste of your time. Second, you can say to yourself, well, he's got a lot of good ideas here. I'll give him a trial. If this is your reaction, I prophesy failure. Third, you can take the advice of one of the greatest minds ever produced, Benjamin Franklin. If he were alive today, he would tell you to select your own personal success plan based on the successful experience of others, and then follow that plan religiously, one step at a time. I don't know whether you're a printer, a salesman, a banker, or a pushcart peddler. It really doesn't make any difference. Listen to what happened to me. Then select 13 of the principles I've put to use in my work and my life and apply them to yourself. If you concentrate on one principle at a time, apply it to your work for 1 week, then use another one for the second week. By concentrating on one at a time, you will get farther with it in 1 week than you otherwise would in a year. A new confidence will take hold of you. At the end of 13 weeks, I know you will be surprised with your progress. By the time you repeat the second 13 weeks, everybody will see in you a greatly different person. Like so many young fellows who later became successful in the business world, I didn't start out as a salesman. I was a professional baseball player. I had played on teams in some of the minor leagues, and because I loved what I was doing, I generated a lot of enthusiasm. Consequently, a few years, I moved up to the majors, third baseman for the St. Louis Cardinals. As I said before, I was several years younger in those days, loaded with enthusiasm about baseball, and able to tell my own story in my own way.
Then one day in the early spring, we were playing the Chicago Cubs at the old ballpark in Chicago. The Cubs had one man on in the first inning when part of their powerhouse, a big slugging outfielder, came to bat. He connected with the first pitch. But it was a swinging bunt rolling down the third baseline. It caught us by surprise. I grabbed the ball on the run and with the same motion turned to fire it over to first. That's when it happened. It felt as though my arm came out of the socket in my shoulder. Later that evening, I couldn't lift my arm to eat dinner with it. I waited for the doctor's opinion.
Sorry to keep you waiting, Frank. I picked up your x-rays at the lab. Here they are.
I never could make sense out of those fuzzy pictures, Doc. What do they mean?
No bone damage, but a severely torn muscle and a badly inflamed tendon.
Well, it could be worse. Better than two broken legs.
I don't know, Frank. I honestly don't.
What kind of answer is that?
Time is the best answer. I've treated hundreds of baseball injuries similar to yours. With proper rest, some of them healed themselves. With others, It was no more baseball forever. Young man on his way down.
Have you ever heard of a man being haunted by an echo? Well, it happened to me. 6 months went by. My sore arm seemed to be improving, yet I still couldn't throw a baseball with any power behind it. That was bad enough, but the worst part was, every time I tried and failed, I could hear the echo of that Chicago doctor's voice.
With others, it was no more baseball forever.
I guess the manager of the Cardinals must have heard the same echo. At the beginning of the next season, I was traded to Montreal. It was mighty cold in Canada, especially for a ball player with a glass arm. They put me out in right field. When a ball came out there, the second baseman raced out to me to relay the ball back to the infield. That's exactly what happened. The only catch was, I had to snap the ball to him underhand. I tried. Tried as I could. And then came the echo.
With others, it was no more baseball forever.
The next day, the president of the club put it to me straight.
Frank, we don't believe your arm will ever get any better in this cool climate. I talked to St. Louis last night and talked it over with them. They've decided to send you to Chattanooga, Tennessee in the Southern League. Here's your train ticket. To check, pays you up to date.
So I took my glass arm and went to New Orleans, where the Chattanooga club was playing for a few days. At least I knew someone on the team, Gabby Street, the catcher, who a few years later became manager of the St. Louis Cardinals. But Gabby couldn't change the inevitable. The only difference was that this time, it came in the form of a typewritten letter. I picked it up at the hotel desk, read it, then went up to the room Gabby and I shared.
Betch, what's wrong? You look like you've been hit over the head with a baseball bat.
Hit with a ball club, you mean?
I don't get it.
Here, read this.
Mr. Frank Bettger, dear sir, this is to notify you of your unconditional release by the St. Louis National League Baseball Club and the Chattanooga Baseball Club effective immediately. Enclosed fine check covering salary to date. Yours truly.
I just haven't got brains enough to listen to an echo.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.